good morning. In the last class, we have seen that atomic magnetic moment, that is the value Pm. Pm is equals to the product of current into area. So where the electron moves in the circular orbit. So okay, today's topic is the Langevin theory of dimagnetism. So before starting the Langevin theory, we have to know the Lenz law. That is, we already studied in the same two. That is, when a diamagnetic material is placed. We already know the definition of a diamagnetic material, that is weakly attracted by the magnet and moves from stronger to weaker part of the field. Okay, so we already know that in the diamagnetic material, the net magnetic moment of each atom is zero. Okay, the net magnetic moment of each atom is zero. Okay, this is according to definition of diamagnetic substances or diamagnetic materials. So when this diamagnetic material is placed in the external magnetic field, so what happened? Okay, there is a induced current is produced. Okay, and this induced current is produced due to which opposes the external magnetic field. That means the induced current is produced. Okay, and this is produced opposite to external magnetic field. Okay, so we already know net magnetic moment of diamagnetic substances is zero, and when these substances are placed in the external magnetic field, so there is an induced current is produced and which has a direction opposite to the external magnetic field. Okay, so this is the Lenz law. This is called the Lenz law. Means the induced current is produced which has a direction opposite to the external magnetic field. And this is described by the Lenz law. Okay. So each electron experiences a Lorentz force or the magnetic force in the direction perpendicular to its motion. Each electron experience, this is called the Lorentz force, or simply we can say that the magnetic force. Due to this external magnetic field and which has a direction perpendicular to its motion. Okay, so this magnetic force in a direction perpendicular to its motion. Okay, so each electron experiences the Lorentz force or the magnetic force. We can see that simple magnetic force, and is perpendicular to its to the direction of electron. Okay, so where the electron moves in clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction is depend on the motion. Okay, so due to this Lorentz force. Okay, so due to this, the angular velocity of electron changes. Due to this, angular velocity of electron changes. Okay, so due to this, all this process, angular velocity of electron changes, and due to this, as the angular velocity of the electron changes, so as a result, the magnetic moment of electron also changes. So due to this, magnetic moment of electron changes. Okay. In the starting, where net magnetic moment of each atom is zero, and as the angular velocity of electron changes, the magnetic moment of electron also changes. So due to this, So the net magnetic moment of an atom is not zero, means which has a certain value, but some magnetic moment is induced in an atoms in the direction opposite to the external magnetic pole moment. This magnetic moment changes and in the direction opposite to the direction of external magnetic field. Okay. So the change in the magnetic moment of electron and changes. So that's why the net magnetic moment starting. We all know the net magnetic moment of each atom is zero. So due to this, all the changes induce current, and due to this induced current, electron experience Lorentz force, and due to this Lorentz force, angular velocity of electron changes. As the angular velocity of electron changes, there is a induced magnetic moment. Due to this induced current, magnetic moment of electron changes, and therefore the net magnetic moment, okay, initially zero. So there is a change in the magnetic moments. So due to this change in the magnetic moment, some magnetic moment is induced in an atom in the direction opposite to the external magnetic field. Therefore, net magnetic moment is not zero, which has a certain specific values. Okay, suppose an electron of mass small m, which has the mass small m and charge small e, is revolving around the nucleus. This electron revolving around the nucleus in an orbit, okay, and which has the radius r0, okay, which in this the r0 is the radius of the circular orbit, and there is a omega 0 is the angular velocity of the electron. Okay, then v0 is the linear velocity of electron. So the electron moves under the circular orbit or moving around the circular orbit, and we already know in the up to 12th science the electron revolving in the circular orbit, and it is due to the centripetal force. Okay, the centripetal force acting towards the radius or towards the center of this circular orbit, and this value we can write this centripetal force acting on electron. Okay, so this is denoted by the letter Fe. So Fe is equals to, we already know centripetal force is equals to mv square by r. Here the notification v0 and r0. So as we know the relation between the linear velocity and angular velocity, that is v is equals to r omega. So they are here v0 is equals to r0 omega 0. So put this value, this Fe is equals to m v0 square, means r0 square and omega 0 square divided by r0. So this r0 cancel, we get the value of centripetal force is equals to m r0 omega 0 square. So this is the value of centripetal force. This is the first equation. Okay, so when the external field is applied, external magnetic field is applied, so due to this external magnetic field, suppose the magnetic there is a magnetic induction, and which is perpendicular to and directed into the plane of paper is applied, that is The magnetic induction is applied, that is letter B, is applied into the plane of paper. Okay, means into the plane of paper, directed towards the plane of the paper. So the an additional force, this is called the additional Lorentz force. Additional Lorentz force. So this is, we write as a F, this is a centripetal force Fe, and this is the magnetic force, we can say that. So for that we take Fm, and we already know the Lorentz force, that is Fm is equals to B, E and V. Okay, so here V is the linear velocity of the electron, E is a charge on electron, and B is the magnetic induction B. So this is the second equation. Okay, so these are the two forces applied acting on the electrons when the external magnetic field, or the when electron is placed in the external magnetic field, or the diamagnetic substances. Okay, so diamagnetic substances is placed in the external magnetic field. These two types of forces acts on the electron. So as the electron moving, okay, as the electron moving in clockwise direction, as electron moves in anticlockwise direction, so therefore the current is produced in the clockwise direction, or this is responsible for the current in the clockwise direction. Current in clockwise direction. And this value of current, that is I is equals to E by T. As seen in the last class, this current is equals to E by T. E is the charge on electron. Okay, so this is the charge on electron, and this T is the time period. Time period of electron. Okay, so I is equals to E by T. So the resulting, so that's why the resulting magnetic moment of electron's orbit is directed into the plane of paper. The direction of magnetic moment, okay, so this is the diagram to denote the direction of magnetic moment. So this is the center, and this is the centripetal force, that is m r 0 omega 0, m r 0 omega 0 square, and this is the direction of angular velocity omega 0. Okay, and this is the radius R0. Okay, so this is the first diagram. In this diagram we already seen that the resulting magnetic moment of electron orbit is directed into the plane of paper. So this is the figure A, means the magnetic moment, magnetic moment into the plane of paper. Okay, because this is the anticlockwise direction. Electron was in the anticlockwise direction, and this is the second figure. In this figure, the electron moves in the clockwise direction. That is the magnetic moment. Out of the plane of paper. Okay, so these are the two diagrams in which the magnetic moment, in the first diagram, as the electron moves in the anticlockwise direction, the magnetic moment is into the plane of paper, figure A, and as the electron moves in the clockwise direction, The magnetic moment is out of the plane of the paper. This is the figure V. Okay. And in that diagram, we already seen that. And this is the diagram for no field. When no field.